life is what you make it, as someone once observed, a phrase that sounds a trifle glib. But whoever thought it out, clearly never sorted out that vexing problem of Adam's spare rib. Chastity, I take it, is specially reserved for those possessing moral fibres. Mine fail me all the time, and maybe that's the reason I'm a bar black sheep, calling all subscribers. Time and again I make good resolutions, but somehow they don't seem to stay. Just when I think I've got the whole thing sewn up, I must own up, everything gets blown up. Sex and champagne as social institutions stampede me and lead me astray. I begin beginning, and my spring cleaning is ditched, bitched, bundled away. All my instincts respond to an amiable blonde, which is fatal. Or if some brisk brunette appears, back go my ears, old Adam cheers. Maybe it's all prenatal. How can I train my hormone distributions to be less aggressively male? Time and again I try, time and again I fail. Moralists disparage a variable heart and say that it should be fenced in, but they never think about defective means of casting out that dear old die-hard original sin. Table d'hôte is marriage, free love's a la carte, but if you cross forbidden fruits or you merely find that you've unwittingly set out to prove the age-old saying, better with your boots off. Time and again I've tried to form a credo, but somehow I don't seem to learn. Just when I think my guardian angel's winning, I go spinning back to the beginning. I can't refrain from firing a torpedo, a buff or a head or a stern. If I hit my quarry, I can't feel sorry. I'm hooked, cooked, down to a turn. Oh, I frequently wish I could curb my conditioned reflexes. I'll be damned if I sacrifice sugar and spice, to be precise, nothing as nice as sex is. I can't restrain my lecherous libido from slipping and tipping the scale. Time and again I try, time and again, time and again.